Here we are going to discuss the fiber reinforced concrete. FRC can be defined as a composites material consists of mixtures of cement mortar or concrete and discontinuous discrete uniformly dispersed through the shootable fibers. So it may be adapted with some composite materials, not even with the fine and coarse, as well as you can add some other material to be added here to increase the durability of the structure. So there may be discussed in the coming slides. Fiber is a small piece of reinforcing material that can be circular or a flat in shape. So it depends on the type of fiber, it may be the shape will get varied. So the main properties of the fiber reinforced concrete, it will have more tensile strength. That is the major fact to be considered here. Whenever the tensile strength will get increased, the failure will automatically get arrested and the settling will also get arrested. Fibers improve the impact and abrasion resistance of the concrete. So these fibers will improve the impact strength. So if the impact strength will means automatically the whatever we are discussing about the strength factor, it will improve the durability. Whereas in case of impact and abrasion resistance, normally in the road rigid pavement, normally in rigid pavements, this impact condition and abrasion resistance will play a major role. So that adapting some fibers here will improve the durability of the structure. It possesses high compressive strength. So automatically the fiber properties, depends on the fiber properties, the compressive strength of the concrete will get increased. It possesses low thermal and electrical conductivity. That is also to be another advantage. So the fiber is often described by the convenient parameter called aspect ratio. The aspect ratio of the fiber is the ratio of its length to its diameter, L by D ratio. The typical aspect ratio ranges from 30 to 150. So these are the types of fibers: steel fibers, glass fibers, polypropylene fibers, slurry infiltrated fiber concrete, SIFCON, asbestos fiber, and last one is carbon fiber. This is some of the examples which I have taken here. Here we have discussed about the word shotcrete. So you can see that photo. So in those conditions, we are just applying more pressure. So in those conditions, the steel fiber may play a major role to increase the strength. But in the time of repairing conditions, what are the major applications at industrial flooring? So that the impact of the vehicles and the impact of the trolleys will get reduced, so that the life of the flooring will get increased. Warehouses, again more load will be there and impact also there. Overlays, at the time of overlays, like in rigid pavements, the overlay may place a major role to increase the strength with the minimum thickness itself. Tunneling works, so that is the major work of the roadways. So whenever we are going with tunneling, the very good in durability factor is needed, so that the strength of the tunnel will get a good time period. So that using this steel fibers in the time of tunneling will increase the strength factor. And next one is glass fiber. This is the recent introduction in making fiber concrete. It has very high tensile strength of 1020 to 4080 newton per mm square. Glass fiber, which is originally used in conjunction with cement, was found to be affected by alkaline condition of the cement. So normally adapted in conjunction with cement means it may be affected by the alkaline condition. So therefore, alkaline resistant glass fiber by trade name CEMFIL has been developed and used. So to overcome those conditions, a new glass fiber has developed. That name is CEMFIL. AR glass fibers have a density that is similar to that of concrete. So the density itself similar to that of concrete means automatically those concrete and this fiber will get matched to increase the durability of the concrete. It gives better bond between the concrete matrix and the reinforcement. Once both of them with same density means it will easily go. It prevents cracks. That is the main aim of the concrete. Wherever we are adapting fiber, the major aim is to prevent the crack in the structure. The fibers also have elastic modulus, which is significantly higher than the concrete. So that is another major advantage, that having a good elastic modulus comparing with the concrete. This enables the fibers to provide an effective reinforcement during the harder stage of concrete. So this may be act as a minor reinforcement. So that itself increases the strength at the time of testing the structure. So these applications are noise barriers, water ducts and the channels, tunnel lining, railways. Again, so this minute in shape, so the noise barriers will get more in a condition. So reducing the like decibels, you should have studied in physics. So the decibels can be get decreased. Water ducts and the channel sections, and that means in the terms of irrigation purposes. Again, so the water, the seepage will get arrested by arresting the minor air cracks. So tunnel lining as well as in the railways. In railways, there is more vibration in the platform. Whenever we are standing, we can feel that. So that also can be arrested by using those types of fibers. Next is polypropylene fiber. They are having good resilience against shrinkage and temperature cracks. So the another major problem with the concrete is developing some shrinkage and temperature cracks due to variation in temperatures. So it is having low modulus. They have longer elongation under a given load, which means that they can absorb more energy without fracture. So without the failure, that it can be arrested with the help of the polypropylene fiber. The low modulus fibers can be combined with steel fibers, which is the latest trend that we call hybrid technology. So joining of steel and polypropylene fibers, so that may have a new technology to increase the strength factor. It's applicable for structure exposed to atmosphere. So whenever there is more in the atmosphere, so the impact and the loading will always be higher. So that cases, both fibers can be adapters, so to increase the durability property. These fibers can take care of the drying shrinkage, whereas steel cannot perform in wet condition. So alternate conditions, it may those adding with two for different fibers that may work in the stages where in dry as well as in the wet. So whatever the conditions, the fiber will get adapted to those conditions and it will get good result. Application is polypropylene fibers can be used for slabs on grades, airport, highways, pavement, parking areas, bridge deck, overlays, sewer pipes, precast concrete products, etc. So these areas, the major applications of polypropylene fibers can be used. So you can see that those are all are very important conditions, airport, pavements, highway conditions, pavement, parking areas, etc. So those areas, the polypropylene fibers are very much playing a major role in the strength factors. So you can see that this is the polypropylene fiber. This is equivalent to the dia of our hair. So that much finer in shape. And next is slurry infiltrated fiber concrete. SIFCON is a high strength, high performance concrete. It contains high volume percentage of steel fibers. It is also called high volume fibrous concrete. The volume of steel varies from 4 to 20%. So adding the percentage might be maximum of 20%. The SIFCON has no coarse aggregate. It contains only fine sand and additives such as fly ash, micro silica and latex emulsions. That is the main difference with respect to the SIFCON concrete. It has no coarse aggregate, cement, fine sand, as well as some materials like fly ash, micro silica, silica fume, GGBS, etc. are there. So that can be adapted here. Proportions of cement and sand generally used for making SIFCON are 1:1, 1:1.5, or 1:2. So this is the ratio. So you can see that those ratios very minimum, 1:1, or 1:5, or 1:2, so that the cement quantity used here will be high. Cement slurry alone can be used for some application. Some application, there is no need of adding the fine aggregate itself. Cement slurry itself can be used. Generally, fly ash or silica fume equal to 10 to 15% of weight of cement is used in the mix. As we said earlier, we can add some fly ash, micro silica, silica fume, so that here it has mentioned that 10 to 15% of the weight of cement can be used in the mix. The water cement ratio varies between 0.3 to 0.4. since there is no coarse aggregate, water cement ratio can be reduced. What are the applications? Overlays, bridge decks, etc. When it is overlays, there is only to maintain the overlay means the surface to be finished smooth and it should be aesthetic. So for that purposes, in bridge decks, to overcome the cracks in some seismic resistant structures, that means again from overlays also. Precast concrete products like piping in the water, piping used in the water lines, so that is also done by precast only. Aeroscape launching platforms, repair, readaptation, strengthening of the structures. There is no need of a coarse aggregate there. When the spalling of surfaces taken or any cracks has been developed, that can be patched, and there you can adapt it only cement slurry or adding some fly ash and silica fume. So that leads to improve the strength also and also the workability factor also. Concrete mega structures such as offshore and long span structures, solar towers, etc. So these are mega structures, so that heavy loading can be needed here. So in that cases, this adding some fly ash, silica fume and such particles can be used here to improve the strength factor as well as to settle soon, so that can be used for the field as soon as possible.